Yo, this situation with Durant has gotten out of hand. I feel bad about it. I feel bad about my involvement in the situation. I feel bad that it's gotten this far. You know, I met him one time. It was cool, cordial. I'm a fan. I met him as a fan. And the funny thing is, he actually had reached out to me about doing something that I call on social media the shame game, about putting people who talk shit on social media on blast. That was actually the way we met. It's not the first time I've posted people's DMs. It's funny when people are saying anti-Semitic things about me, saying racist things about me, threatening me, and they're Joe Schmoes. Everybody loves it. But when it was Durant, you know, people got 400 opinions. I'm a rat. Fuck all that rat shit. You know, like I said, we met, he was cordial. And I hadn't seen him since, you know, but it was definitely cool. But I don't consider him a friend. The way he was talking to me is not like a person who was a friend. I don't speak to friends like that. I don't banter with friends telling them, yo, when I see you, I'm going to spit in your face. Ha ha ha. Oh, cool. When you spit in my face, I'm going to swish it around and spit in your face. That's not the way I banter. That's not the way I bullshit. That's not the way, that's not locker room talk. Those are threats. They were made over and over and over. You know, it's been going on for months. And on Tuesday of this week, he caught me on a bad day. That being said, in my opinion, the whole situation got blown out of proportion. I don't premeditate or contrive my, behavior, my rants. On social media, they come from the gut. That's why people, I think, respond to them, whether I'm talking about politics, sports, or whatever. But, you know, you live and learn. I know I have lived and learned from the situation. I've had to deal with ramifications that, you know, I'll keep to myself. And I know he has. And, you know, I feel bad about it. But it is what it is, and we have to move forward.